I don't want to define myself and my life by what I do for a living. I want to define my life by community service and helping.
You have to do something. You have to feel that you're contributing and building and sustaining a Jewish vibrant community.
I have stayed involved because my dedication to Jewish education, I think, is the most important aspect of living in the diaspora. If you don't have Jewish education, you'll have assimilation and you'll just disappear as an individual people.
Jewish education is a communal function. And if one lives in a community, they should partake in the important aspects of the community that benefit everybody in the long run.
This is your school. This is your school, and you make it your school by becoming involved. When you give of yourself, you get it back.
I look at the school today, and I'm quelling about it. It's an extraordinary institution, and I don't know, I just get a lot of pleasure from it. It goes two ways. I give, but I get to.
I was one of the original four or five people around when the whole concept of starting a Hebrew high school in Berkman County was developed. The group that was involved were involved in the interest of Jewish education. They weren't involved in seeing how their personal needs could be satisfied. There was no Hebrew high school in Berkman County at that time. Through some circumstance, Rabbi Swift, together with Abe Kremer and Joe Nelson, two people that were involved in Jewish education for a number of years, approached Mr. Frisch about starting a Hebrew high school. He kind of jumped at the idea. During the whole process of putting up the school, he always said, "I will put up the school and you run it."
Frisch at 40 is an accomplishment. I give a lot of credit to the people who started. It's not easy to start a school. I got involved 15 years ago when my children started coming to Frisch. I think I'm involved mostly because of the excitement of watching the children grow. And I have tremendous respect for the Rebbeim and the teachers here. I remember being at board meetings when I was a young lad starting out. We were in the old Frisch building and we were outgrowing it. And we were discussing whether to move, whether to cap enrollment. And there was a discussion and we decided to move forward.
The catalyst for my involvement in Frisch was our belief in Jewish education and the philosophy that Frisch offered for our children. What we're attempting to do today is no different what the founders attempted to do 40 years ago. Yes, we do it in a much larger building, a state-of-the-art facility. They wanted to establish a co-ed, a quality educational system, which was both religious and secular at the same time, and an educational system that challenges each and every individual child to meet its full potential.
My own involvement came after my children graduated. I was invited in by Stan Turetz. I've always believed that that those who are capable should be helping out in community institutions. Frisch is a pearl for the Jewish community of the Berkman County in here, and it deserves everyone's support. I found myself getting involved in the school at the beginning of what I would call the transition period for Frisch. The demand in the community for a high school of this nature had increased quite a bit, and so we came to the conclusion that we needed to grow.
My biggest accomplishment was leading the design and acquisition and ultimately the construction of the new Frisch School, which is now, I think, probably one of the nicest high schools in the United States. The key is to deliver a very good, excellent educational product, which we did in the old building too. I mean, that hasn't changed. I think it's been enhanced because we have more space. Chuck Feldman, Oliver Shalom, may he be rest in peace, was one of those inner people that basically taught me that very important lesson, that if you want to run an educational institution, hire the best people you can, let them run the educational facility, and keep your nose out of the day-to-day. Our job is to raise money and to watch and make sure that the mission of Frisch continues.
Chuck and I, we completely believe in this. You know, it's just the foundation of our souls that we believe in yeshiva education. And Frisch is bigger than being a school in Bergen County. It is a school that represents excellence and education and preparing the next generation of Jews. When Frisch was in the position of a search for a principal, and he met with Dr. Stein, identified him as truly the right person for the job. And if Chuck were here today, he would say that is his proudest legacy to Frisch.
Everybody contributed in his own way. All the presidents and all the people that were involved, each had their own imprimatur and their own personal fingerprint. And they left the mark that, you know, you can't replace, but the sum total of everybody's involvement led to what we have today.
The thing I received from Frisch was the idea of transmitting to my children, working for the community. It was a thrill when my daughter called from Israel and had a class and they spoke about community service. And she said, now I understand why Daddy was away all those nights. That to me said it all.
I benefit more than third parties benefit. I enjoy what I'm doing and I feel I'm contributing to our people. It keeps me young, keeps me active, and keeps me interested. I've benefited far more than anything that I might have contributed.
The truth is that almost any parent can contribute to the school. There are committees, there are the Frisch Parent Association. There's always room for anybody, no matter what they think their strengths and weaknesses are. Well, personally, I find that I get a lot of nachas from it.
Rather than stay on the sidelines and just send your child to school, become active, involved, and you will be enriched by it as well. And the school needs it. The school needs your support. It needs new people. It's a community. It's not just a school where you send your children and you stay home. It has to be involved. It has to involve parents to help support the school.
One of the thrills I had, one of the most important moments I had as president was in September 2007 when we changed and we moved to this campus. I watched 600 Jewish students come to a brand new school, and all I could think of was that here I had the privilege and the great honor and the schus to watch 600 Jewish children, free Jewish children, without fear, coming to a Jewish school. And all I could think of were my grandparents.
And that is the legacy, to continue that direction of not closing ourselves in from the outside world, embracing the values of the outside world, and embracing it all within the foundation of Torah and Halacha, and preparing kids to go out into the world, into the universities, to go to Israel, and into professional life as these very solid Torah-based American citizens.
I'm very encouraged that a lot of young families who are now having children entering Frisch have decided to get involved, and that's the future. We have to dedicate yourself to Jewish education if you want to have a facility like Frisch that dedicates itself to educational excellence.
It's almost like having a little baby that you see, a baby born and then grows. When I walk into Frisch, I stand in the lobby, and I fell. It's a wonderful feeling to feel that you've done something creative, substantial, lasting, and worthwhile.